This video is about power and calculating power. What is power? Power is the amount of energy being transferred per unit time, or the amount of work done per unit time. So this kettle can boil 3 cups of water faster than this one because its power rating is higher. The amount of energy it transfers electrically per second is greater. Or the left-hand motor can lift the same weight higher than the right-hand one in the same amount of time, because it can do more work on the weight in that time. The unit for power is the watt, which is equal to 1 joule per second, or 1 newton meter per second. Let's take a look at an example exam question. A fairground amusement uses the arrangement shown in the diagram to measure the individual power rating of customers. The mass of the load on the system is 35 kilograms. The length of the rope able to pass through the pulley is 1.4 meters. The man pulled the rope as hard as he could, and the time taken was measured to be 1.3 seconds. Determine the power rating of the man for 3 marks. So we know the mass at 35 kilograms, and we know the length of rope passing through the pulley, which is the distance at 1.4 meters, and we know the time taken, which is 1.3 seconds. So let's clear a bit of space. We're asked to calculate power, and we know that power is equal to energy transferred per unit time. And we're given time, so that's a really good starting point. We know that energy transferred is equal to work done. So how can we use the values we've been given to get to work done? Well, we know that mechanical work done is force times distance. And we're given the distance, so we're almost there. The force in this scenario is going to be the weight of the load. And we know that weight is equal to mass times the gravitational field strength. So we're given mass, and we know that G is equal to 9.8 newtons per kilogram. So we have G. And now we have all the variables needed to solve the equation. You could just plug the numbers into the equation as it is here, and you would gain full marks. But I'm going to break it down into steps. So firstly, to calculate the weight of the load, we write out the equation. We substitute in the known values, where mass is 35 kilograms and gravitational field strength is 9.8 newtons per kilogram, giving a weight of 343 newtons for 1 mark. Next, we calculate the work done, which is force times distance, or in this case, weight times distance. Notice how I've used the word work here in the equation to make it clear where I'm referring to work and where I'm referring to weight, because they both have the symbol W. Anything that makes your calculation clearer is great. Don't be afraid to use markers, like writing out calculating weight, calculating work. If the situation calls for it, you can absolutely use words to explain your process. So then we substitute in the known values, the weight we just calculated at 343 newtons, and the distance at 1.4 meters. And that gives work done is equal to 480.2 newton meters or joules. And that's the second mark. Then the final step is to calculate power. So power is the work done per unit time. And substituting in those known values gives us work from step 2 at 480.2 newton meters and time at 1.3 seconds, giving us a final answer of 369 watts for the final mark. Notice how there was a lot of work to do here for 3 marks. That means this is a difficult question, the kind of question you would find towards the end of an exam paper. The questions get harder as you go through the paper, but also the amount of work you have to do for each mark increases as well. In summary, power is the amount of energy transferred per unit time, or the electrical or mechanical work done per unit time. A higher power rating means that more energy is transferred or more work is done in the same amount of time, or that the same amount of energy is transferred or the same amount of work is done in a faster time. Remember that multi-step calculations are common in exam questions on power, so make sure your working out is clearly laid out as demonstrated in this video. Don't forget to check out all our other fantastic revision resources here at Save My Exams.